Hello dear students, welcome to today's English class. We are going to study today simple past tense. Simple past tense is used to describe an action that got over at a definite time in the past. Okay students? So today what we are going to study, we are going to focus today on when to use simple past tense and how to form sentences using past form of verb. Past form of verb means action words past form. How simple past tense is used? We will see in this slide. Simple past tense is used for an action that was completed in the past. Let's make it clear with the help of example. It rained yesterday. I watched a play last Sunday. That means the action was completed in the past. Our next condition of using simple past tense is for a completed action that happened in the past. That means the action is already over. Let us see with the help of an example. She was a banker. That means the action happened in the past. I studied French when I was a kid. That means the action happened in the past. Was and studied French tells you that the action happened in the past. Another condition where simple past tense is used, let us see. Third condition is to show a duration in the past. That means these words show the duration of an action that took place in the past. Okay, so let us make it clear with the help of example. She studied French for 2 years. So, for 2 years is telling you the duration of studying French. He talked over the phone for 30 minutes. Here, for 30 minutes is the duration in the past. So, how long did he talk over the phone? He talked for 30 minutes. Students, let us understand the structure, how to form simple past tense. Okay, subject and past form of verb and rest of the sentence. Let us make it clear with the help of example. He is the subject here. Lost is the past form of action verb. Lose, his phone yesterday. Rest of the sentence. That means he lost his phone yesterday. The action had already happened. Okay, students? So you have to keep these few things in mind while framing the sentence in simple past tense. Students, are you confused? Confused where to add ed in the verb and where to add ied in the verb. Okay, I will make it clear. Students, let us understand with the help of rule 1. Rule 1 tells you that you have to be careful with the verbs that end with e. For example, like, smile, dance, type, figure. So what you have to do is you have to drop E. See, in smile, there is E in the last. In dance, there is E in the last. In type, there is E in the last. And figure, there is E in the last. All these words have E in the end. So, what you have to do is, you have to drop E and add ED to the verb to form simple past tense. That means, Smile will become smiled. Dance will become danced. Type will become typed. Figure will become figured. Okay, students? Rule number two for adding ed. So what you have to do is you have to double the consonant and add ed to verbs that end with one vowel and one consonant. Let us make it clear with the help of example. So in the first example, you will see the word is stop, S-T-O-P. It is the combination of one vowel and one consonant, because you can see in the end there is O-P, vowel and consonant. It will become stopped when we will change it into simple past tense. Similarly, drag. Drag comprises of D-R-A-G. It is a combination of one vowel and one consonant G. Okay. When we will change it into simple past tense, it will become dragged. Similarly, admit will become admitted when we will change it into simple past tense. Okay, students? There are also a lot of confusions in using IED. Students are confused where to use IED. Let me make it clear with the help of this explanation. Let us see. What you have to do is you have to replace IED when the verb is ending with Y. Okay, let's see it with the help of example. Carry will become carried because carry is ending with Y. Cry will become cried because it is ending with Y. Try will become tried when it is changed into simple past tense. Okay. So students, let us see what we studied today. We studied the basic concepts or the basic confusion when to use simple past tense and how to form simple past tense. And we cleared a lot of confusions where to use ed and where to use IED. I hope this is clear to all of you. You can replay the slide again and again to make your confusions clear. Okay, students? That's all for today. Have a nice day.